Dear students, welcome to the lecture 17. Before starting today's lecture, let's have a look on recap of the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we have learned about the various type of organic reactions, that is addition reaction, substitution reaction, elimination reaction and the rearrangement reactions. Then we have started learning about the addition reaction in detail, which includes definition and its types. We have learned that the addition reaction is of three types, that is electrophilic addition, nucleophilic addition and the free radical addition reaction. Among these, we have started with the electrophilic addition reactions in the previous lecture and learned about the Markovnikov rule. Now let us start with today's lecture. Dear students, today we are going to learn about the nucleophilic addition reactions in detail. What is the nucleophilic addition reaction? A nucleophilic addition reaction is the addition reaction in which nucleophile is the electron rich center, that means nucleophile attacks on the carbon atom which is electrophile. So these are the addition reaction in which attacking species is the nucleophile and substrate, that means the organic molecule having the electrophilic carbon center. This is the basic type of the nucleophilic addition reaction. These reactions are considered very important in organic chemistry since they enable the conversion of the carbonyl group in a variety of the functional groups. So basically, nucleophilic addition reactions are those reactions in which attacking species is the nucleophile and this nucleophile attacks on the carbon atom of the substrate molecule which occupies the partially positive charge. So nucleophile is the electron rich center. This electron rich center attacks on the electron deficient carbon atom of the substrate molecule, resulted in the final product. So now question, what are the carbonyl compounds? As you all know that the carbonyl compounds are the organic compounds having the functional group CO, carbonyl functional group. Basically, the carbonyl compounds are categorized as aldehydes, ketones and the acids. Aldehydes are the carbonyl compounds in which this CO group is attached with one of the alkyl group and second hydrogen, that means HCOR are the aldehydes, while ketones are the carbonyl compounds in which CO group is attached with two alkyl groups. And third category is the acids, in which CO group is attached with the alkyl group and second attached group is the OH group, that means RCOOH is the acids. So these are the carbonyl compounds or the compounds having the functional group CO, that is carbonyl functional group, aldehydes, ketones and the acids. Now question comes, why do carbonyl compounds undergo nucleophilic addition reaction? Reason behind this is, in carbonyl compounds the carbon oxygen bond, this bond is polar. Owing to the higher electronegativity of the oxygen atom, the electron density is higher near the oxygen atom. Because electronegativity of oxygen is higher than the carbon, so these pi bond electrons are moves towards the oxygen due to its higher electronegativity. Due to this polarity, the oxygen of the carbonyl group occupies partially negative charge and carbon occupies partially positive charge. So due to this polarity of CO bond, the carbon atom of the carbonyl occupies the partially positive charge, that means it behaves as an electrophile. therefore undergo in the nucleophilic addition reactions. Now, come towards the mechanism of the nucleophilic addition reaction. Generally, the nucleophilic addition reaction of carbonyl compounds involves three steps. First, the electrophilic carbon forms a sigma bond with the nucleophile. This is the nucleophile, that means electron rich center. In the first step, this nucleophile attacks on the electrophilic carbon atom of the carbonyl group and forms the single bond with this carbonyl group. In the second step, the carbon oxygen pi bond is now broken and forming the alkoxide intermediate. Since this nucleophile attacks on the carbon atom, so there is the formation of the single bond between the carbon atom and the nucleophile. There is the single bond formation between these, and the pi bond electron are now moves towards the oxygen. So oxygen occupies the negative charge. So there is the single bond between the nucleophile and the carbon atom, and another single bond is between the carbon atom and the oxygen atom, and the pi bond electrons are now moves towards the oxygen. So the oxygen occupies the negative charge. This is the alkoxide intermediate in which the carbonyl carbon atom is now tetrahedral, because it forms four covalent bonds, two with the substituent groups, another maybe alkyl group or hydrogen, and third one is with the nucleophile, and fourth sigma bond is with the oxygen. So this is the alkoxide intermediate. Now in the last step, the subsequent protonation of the alkoxide yields the alcohol derivative. Since now oxygen occupies the negative charge, so it combines with the hydrogen and forms the OH. That means finally the alcohol derivative is formed. From where this H comes? Look at the reaction again. This nucleophile actually is in this form, H and nucleophile, where H is positive and nucleophile is the negative. For example, HOH it may be. So this H comes from the counterpart of the attacking reagent. So in the first step, nucleophile attacks on the carbonyl carbon atom and forms the sigma bond with the carbonyl carbon atom, and now the electrons moves towards the oxygen of the carbonyl. Hence there is the formation of the alkoxide intermediate takes place. This alkoxide intermediate now, due to the protonation, forms the alcohol derivative. You must remember that the carbonyl group has a coplanar structure and its carbon is the sp2 hybridized, but when it undergoes in nucleophilic addition reaction and forms the alcohol derivative or the product, in the product this carbonyl carbon atom is now sp3 hybridized, because the carbon atom forms four sigma bonds now in the final product. Therefore, before the reaction, the carbonyl carbon atom is sp2 hybridized, and after nucleophilic addition in the product, this carbon is now sp3 hybridized. Now time for check your learning. Which of the following properties of the carbonyl group allows aldehyde and ketones to undergo nucleophilic addition reactions? Polarity of the carbon and oxygen bond, size of the carbon atom, the number of the electrons present in the covalent bond, or the number of the hydrogen atom present? Pause the video for a minute and think about this question. Yes, You all are right. The reason behind this, the polarity of the carbon and oxygen bond. Because due to the polarity, the carbon occupies partially positive charge, which makes the carbon electrophile. Hence, it undergoes in the nucleophilic addition reaction. Does carbonyl compounds react in the same manner with all the nucleophile? Just think. Answer is, depending on the reactivity of the nucleophile, there are two possible general scenario. Carbonyl compounds react differently with the strong nucleophile and weak nucleophiles. That means the anionic nucleophiles, that means the attacking species having the negative charge, reacts differently with the carbonyl compound, while the neutral nucleophiles reacts differently with the carbonyl compounds. First, the strong nucleophile, that means the nucleophile possesses the negative charge. These type of nucleophiles add directly to the carbonyl group to form the alkoxide intermediate, and this alkoxide intermediate is then protonated and forms the final product. This is the example. Nucleophile attacks on the electrophilic carbon of the carbonyl group and forms the sigma bond with this, and alkoxide intermediate is formed. Finally, this alkoxide intermediate reacts with the proton and forms the alcohol derivative. So, with these strong nucleophiles, nucleophilic addition takes place in the basic medium. Example of the strong nucleophiles are RMGX, Grignard reagent, alkyl lithium compound, lithium aluminium hydride, and sodium boron hydride. While weaker nucleophiles requires that the carbonyl group be activated prior to attack to the nucleophile, because these nucleophiles are the weaker, that means these nucleophiles are comparatively less active. Means it requires, this type of nucleophile requires that more positive charge should be on the carbon atom. So, it can attract the weaker nucleophiles as well. For example, with reaction with the weak nucleophiles, the carbon atom of the carbonyl group must be protonated. This type of reaction. So these reactions are taking place in presence of acid catalyst. The protons from the acid catalyst reacts with the oxygen of the carbonyl group. Hence, now this oxygen forms the single bond with the proton of the acid catalyst. Due to formation of this bond, the oxygen of the carbonyl atom is now attracts the electrons of the carbonyl group. Hence, the carbon atom of the carbonyl group is become more electrophilic, because the electrons are now moved towards the oxygen of the carbonyl group. Hence, the carbon atom of this carbonyl group is electron deficient now. So, due to this electron deficiency, this carbon atom is now more electrophilic nature. So, due to its electron deficiency, it attracts the nucleophile with the greater attraction force. So, now the nucleophilic addition reaction taking place, and nucleophile attacks on the electron deficient carbon atom and forms the intermediate. And now the proton of the remaining part of the attacking species reacts with the base, and this bond will break, and finally formation of the alcohol derivative. So I am again repeating that weak weaker nucleophile requires that the carbonyl group be activated prior to attack of the nucleophile. Why this activation is necessary? Because if this carbonyl group is protonated, and due to the protonation of this, oxygen reacts with the proton supplied by the acid catalyst. Now, due to the protonation, the bonding electrons of the carbonyl group move towards the oxygen, and the carbon atom of the carbonyl group, this carbon atom become more electron deficient, and due to the electron deficiency, it attracts the nucleophiles now with the more greater attraction force. So, this type of activation is necessary because the nucleophiles are weaker. Therefore, after protonation, this electrophilic carbon atom attracts more the nucleophile. Hence, the nucleophile now forms the sigma bond with the electrophilic carbon atom, and finally the product formation taking place. So, with the weaker nucleophiles, the nucleophilic addition reactions takes place in the acidic medium. Examples of such nucleophiles are water, alcohol, and the primary amines. Now think, is there any difference in the reactivity of aldehyde and ketone towards the nucleophilic addition? Yes, aldehydes are more reactive than ketones because the steric and the electronic effects makes the aldehydes more reactive. Consider first the steric effect. This is the aldehyde structure and this is the ketone structure. In aldehyde, the carbonyl carbon atom is bonded with the alkyl group and with the hydrogen. While in ketone, the carbonyl carbon atom is bonded both of the alkyl groups. So, in aldehydes, the relatively small hydrogen atom is attached to one side of the carbonyl group, while a larger R group is affixed to the another side. This, while in ketone, both sides of the carbonyl groups are attached with the larger alkyl group. Thus, steric hindrance is less in aldehyde than in ketone. Suppose this nucleophile attacks on the carbonyl carbon atom. So here one side of the carbonyl carbon atom is the alkyl group and second is the smaller hydrogen. So nucleophiles faces less steric hindrance in the aldehydes, while this nucleophile when attacks on the carbonyl carbon atom of the ketones, in the ketones the carbon atom surrounds with the larger alkyl groups, hence the nucleophile faces the more steric hindrance, hence aldehydes are more reactive, can easily react with the nucleophile, while due to the steric hindrance, the ketones are less reactive towards the nucleophilic addition reaction. This is the first reason. Second reason is the electronic effects. Electronically, aldehydes have only one R group, that means one alkyl group, to supply electrons towards the partially positive carbon atom. We know that alkyl group are the electron releasing groups. So, the alkyl group supply the electrons towards the carbon atom, that means this decreases the partial positive characteristic of the carbonyl group. As the partial positive characteristics decreases, the nucleophilic attack chances also decreases. So, in the aldehydes, there is the one alkyl group. So, these are the more reactive because decrease in the partial positive characteristic in aldehyde is less, while in ketone the carbonyl carbon atom is attached with the two alkyl groups. Here So, the greater amount of electrons being supplied to the carbonyl carbon atom, hence the less partial positive charge on the carbonyl carbon atom, hence it becomes weaker electrophile as compared to the aldehyde. So, due to both these reasons, steric reasons and the electronic effects, aldehydes are more reactive than the ketones. Now, these are some examples of the nucleophilic addition reaction. First, the nucleophiles having the carbon atom. For example, HCN. When HCN reacts with the aldehyde or ketone, it forms the cyanohydrins. Student, please see all the examples and try to study the detailed mechanism of all types of these reactions. The mechanism is the same as we have already discussed earlier. These are the examples with the nitrogen containing nucleophiles, reaction with the primary amines and secondary amines. These are the reactions with the oxygen containing nucleophiles, that is reaction with the H2O, reaction with the alcohols. Now, time to check your learning. See this reaction, propanone, that means this ketone, and hydrogen cyanide reacts together by this mechanism. Look at this reaction. Which statement about this mechanism are correct? Cyanide is an electrophile. This is the type of addition reaction, or heterolytic bond breaking is involved. Pause the video for a minute and think about the question. Yes, you are right. The correct answer is second and third. It is the type of addition reaction, right? And heterocyclic bond breaking is involved. Heterolytic bond breaking is involved. While the first one option is incorrect, because we know this is the negatively charged species. So it is the nucleophile. It is not the electrophile. Let us revise what we have learned today. Today we have learned about the nucleophilic addition reaction, definition of the nucleophilic addition reaction and its mechanism. We have learned that it involves the three steps. Then effect of the nature of the nucleophile on mechanisms of the addition reaction. We have learned that the carbonyl compounds reacts differently with the strong nucleophile and the weaker nucleophile. In presence of the acid, the weak nucleophile reacts more rapidly. Then we have learned about the comparison of the reactivity of aldehyde and ketone towards the nucleophilic addition reaction. We learned that aldehydes are more reactive towards the nucleophilic addition reaction due to the steric and the electronic reasons. Then we have learned the examples of the nucleophilic addition reaction, in which we seen that different kind of nucleophilic addition reactions with oxygen containing nucleophiles, nitrogen containing nucleophiles and the carbon containing nucleophiles. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you. Take good care of yourself and stay safe and healthy at home, and keep learning.